What is up, guys? My name's Pataclysm, and welcome back-
Patrick was just your everyday small YouTuber, making comedy videos in his bedroom for all 30 of his viewers to see. But little did he know that today's video was about to turn into a horror show.
Back to the channel. Today's video is gonna be a damn good one. Folks! Now, if what I just did there seems familiar, it's a reference to Kurtis Conner, a much bigger and, frankly, a much funnier commentary channel. And the reason I bring him up is because today's video is partially inspired by him. Not too long ago, he made a video about a show on Spike TV called Manswers, and he talked about how ridiculous the premise and execution was. He also made a point to show how ridiculous the premise of Spike TV itself was.
That was the real commercial for Spike TV, I shit you not. Guns, cars, boobs, punches, and boobs again.
And when I watched his video, I started having fucking Jimmy Neutron brain blast memories about Spike TV. Because not only did they make Manswers, but they also made... Can you guess? Can you guess what they made? Can you guess? That's right, Stripperella. See, it's funny because obviously we're going to be talking about 1,000 Ways to Die, but now you know that Stripperella exists. A Stan Lee created adult TV animation voiced by Pamela Anderson with a character called Erotica Jones, who is a stripper by night and a crime fighter later at night. That's their own description right there. It's incredible. Maybe we'll do a video on it in the future, but... But we'll see. But for now, 1,000 Ways to Die. It was a show from 2008 to 2012 where they told the story and reenacted some of the weirdest, craziest, and downright unlucky deaths ever reported. I say reported because a lot of them are really far-fetched just for the sake of entertainment, and we'll see that as we go forward. But regardless, this show is a goddamn gold mine of content. So much so that my biggest problem was finding the episodes to actually react to. But after scouring the internet for the weirdest and most memorable deaths, I was told to react to these three episodes: Embarrassed, Hard On, and A Chainus Runs Through It. I know, the titles are incredible, you don't even need to know the context of them. In fact, here's a list of all the best titles that I found throughout it.
Personally, my favorite is Work of Fart.
The only problem was those clips were not available for free on YouTube, so I had to actually buy the episodes. $2 each. $6 total. I could have bought a Wendy's 4-for-4, and then a half of a 4-for-4. That checks out. I could have got 6-for-6. So I hope it's worth it. So without further ado, let's start with Embarrassed.
This is Randy. He's out of his gourd. He ate a handful of magic mushrooms, and now he's wandering around the desert higher than a kite.
So we start out where all good stories begin, with Randy high in the desert. That's how you know that this guy is truly off his gourd, as they say. Because instead of being in the safety of his basement, watching Family Guy and eating Fritos, he's going, actually, I'm gonna fist fight a rattlesnake today. I think I could take him.
He asked the bushes for an answer and got nothing.
I am.
Randy's really walking out in the desert like, oh, what's this? A no legs having ass bitch? Unhinges the snake's jaw. But like sideways, not the way snakes do.
To anyone not tripping out on mushrooms, Randy would appear to be completely insane. And then things got really weird. At the end of the day, Randy came upon a group of fornicating furries.
Oh my god! This is already incredible, because this was 2009, before furries became, you know, all too well known. And so this is what they they presume furries are. I need to hear more.
What's a furry? People who like to put on animal costumes and get together for fun things like group sex.
I love this so much. Because clearly, if the term fur pile existed, then the normal furries as we know them, and I use the term normal loosely, they exist. But instead of getting the actual furry costumes, they just said, let's just get a bunch of sports mascots, throw them in the desert, and tell them to dry hump each other. You got Meth Head Chicken over here, the actual Easter Bunny. I'm sure somewhere in there there's Garfield and Odie from the Lasagna Cat channel. Kermit the Frog's probably there. Those creepy ass racing presidents with Roosevelt looking like a goddamn psychopath. Fucking Tinky Winky even. The sky's the limit here for who could be in this goddamn desert orgy. What's next for this group?
A furry orgy is often known as a fur pile. We summon our spirit animals, and whatever happens next is whatever, you know, naturally will happen.
Hi, my name is Kevin. I am an intern here at Spike TV. I was told to put on this Winnie the Pooh outfit and claim the name Morning Bear as my furry alter ego. I was also given this ukulele. I don't know how to play it. I think the showrunners are fucking delusional. I make the joke about it, but I guarantee that that guy genuinely was sitting on the sidelines, waiting for his big break, only for the producer to come up to him like, hey kid, what's your name? It's Kevin, sir. Kevin, huh? Well, I got news for you. Your big break is coming today. Oh my god, really? Just tell me what to do. I mean, I can cry on command. I have martial arts training. I've done my own stunts. I can really do whatever. What's this? Congrats, kid. You're a furry now.
Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend.
I'll wag my dino ass for you, Spike TV. Will that get me views? I'll wave around a lightsaber to appeal to your beta male demographic. Will that give me views, Spike TV?
In Randy's state of mind, sex seemed like a great idea. The zebra looked kind of cute.
Hey, get your hands off me.
So getting back to it, Randy tries to get in on the action, but is rejected by everyone.
This orgy was turning tricky. Instead of a threesome with the zebra and the cute beaver, maybe it was time to squeeze some honey out of Ms. Bunny. But the cock shooed Randy away with his pecker.
The cock shooed Randy away with his pecker. Stick around for more 1,000 Ways to Die, only on Spike TV. Get it? I drew a dick and a balls. So after asking everyone for some furry poo-tang, he starts to lose hope. Until...
It looked like Randy would get no love from the animal kingdom. When all of a sudden... There she was. A sultry little furry in a teddy.
Oh boy, I think we all know what's about to happen. He starts fucking the furry in the bear suit. Turns out she was a freak that liked to get rough. Randy didn't know the safe word because he's not a part of the group, and she tore him to bits. Clearly, that's what happened here. The best part about this, though, is that it's happening 20 feet from the furry orgy, and no one's saying anything. You could argue that it's because they have their masks on and maybe they don't see it happen, but you can see in the back, that guy took his mask off. So clearly he saw what was happening and chose to ignore it. He was like, oh my god, I'm really worried about that guy, but I'm also really busy right now. Just give me like 2 more minutes, guy.
Make it 5, bitch.
I'm sorry, 5 more minutes, and then I'll come help you, okay? Take that furry ass. Please don't take that out of context. Even in context, it's not much better, but still. So yeah, that was death number 412, embarrassed, which is a triple pun because it's embarrassed, bear, and bear-assed. So what I'm saying is the genius of the show knows no bounds. Next up, we have Hard-On.
Lucas wasn't exactly a ladies' man. In fact, he never even dated one. Isolated, lonely, this schizophrenic desert rat was traveling down a dark path leading to psychopathic, sexually deviant behavior.
I am not a fan already.
In a smutty magazine, Lucas had learned how to rig a cow heart to a car battery and then use it as a sex toy. He brought home his new date from a local slaughterhouse. The table was set. A fresh cow heart he named Bessie, a fresh battery, and a throbbing stiffy.
You know, I'd like to see a lot of things before I die. I wrote them all down right here. I'd like to see the Great Barrier Reefs in Australia. I want to see the Colosseum in Rome. Hell, if it's possible, I'd like to see space one day. But a man having sex with a cow heart that is beating because it's attached to a car battery? I don't remember ever writing that down.
I don't remember putting that on the list.
Goodbye, my lover. Goodbye, my friend. You have been the one. You have been.
I bought this episode. I paid to see this. What kind of freak am I? What does that say about me?
But it wasn't getting him where he needed to go. He reasoned that if 12 felt good, then 110 volts would feel about 10 times better.
See, plugging it into the wall outlet is where I would say, well, there's your problem. But I think we're way past the initial problem here. All I know is you don't fuck with electricity. Get it? So he plugs it into a wall, it beats faster, not due to science, mind you, but because the creators of the show wanted to remind us that God is dead. And then...
But as soon as the two lovers connected, Lucas went straight to premature electrocution.
He also gets one final roast from a knockoff John C. Reilly.
If you were to put this person in a different time period, he would always stand out. It goes beyond social Darwinism. It's Darwinism to the extreme.
What I think my colleague here is trying to say is that people who have sex with cow hearts are big doo-doo-brained idiots who deserve to die. Stick around for more Thousand Ways to Die, only on Disney. Finally, we have A Chainus Runs Through It. Now, this one's special to me because I don't know or care how the guy dies in this one. The only thing I care about is the Chainus itself. So we're gonna cut right through the bullshit and get right into it. So this tattoo artist works in a parlor where all the artists have pretty crazy piercings and body modifications, including one girl who has a split tongue. In a fit of jealousy to be the talk of the town with body modifications, he comes up with an entirely new form of piercing and comes in to show it off.
Check it out.
Zeke had swallowed a Teflon-coated chain and let it pass through his digestive system, down his Hershey Highway, and out his butt.
I'm gonna call it the Chainus.
The mother fucking Chainus, ladies and gentlemen. Just when we are shown just how low humanity can get, we are shown just how high we can fly. The Chainus, god damn it.
Oh, no, that's gross. Dude. You have a chain running out of your butt into your mouth.
Chainus, gonna make me famous.
You see, by pulling off this bold look and calling it the Chainus, a play on the words chain and anus, this man has prevented all future wars as well as stopped climate change altogether. It's just incredible. I don't care if this was real or created in some writer's room. The Chainus is the greatest thing I've ever heard to come out of TV or any form of media. It's a Chainus! It's amazing!
You've completely lost it, Zeke.
You! You're a dead man!
But Zeke didn't have the time to gloat.
I'm gonna kill you!
Nope! I'm not watching this anymore. I've already decided that I'm gonna go out right now and get myself a Chainus.
Little did Patrick know that getting a Chainus would be a grave mistake. Mm-hmm.
Haters will say it's fucking fake. Haters will say it's fucking fake, dog. But I shit this chain out this morning, I connected it, and I've never felt better. I'm about to take a stroll on the town and enjoy life. Woo!
What Patrick might have realized if he watched the rest of the episode was that having a long dangling chain connected to your inner organs, for God's sakes, is a bad idea. Because he immediately tripped over it down the stairs. And then got it caught in a car door. You have been the one for me.
Thank you for watching. If you liked it, let me know what you think, and maybe subscribe for more videos just like this one. I appreciate you greatly, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one. We might even look at more Thousand Ways to Die deaths, who knows? See ya.